in the 70s, they weren't as advanced at skull reconstruction surgery as they were maybe later in the 80s, 90s, 2000s, and so on. So I'm seeing younger people with similar facial features, but a somewhat more ordinary shaped head, but they have certain anomalies in the way their hair grows. That even with expanding the brain case, if you're not a hybrid, that doesn't mean your brain is, you know, because we have a smaller brain to begin with. So the brain case fits. It's when we mix with other people that sometimes they get the larger brain and the smaller brain case. Then things get squished and they get really bad epilepsy. So with this surgery, a lot of people that would have been like pinheads in the past are having fairly normal lives in a regular society, but still, even with, you know, people get really good at sleight of hand and hairstyles and stuff, and people don't know why your head's a weird shape and stuff like that, they still kind of notice there's something kind of weird about you, and they don't know what it is, and you got all these people saying, well, it was drugs or something. Yeah, drugs made my skull shrink. But, so the thing is, you know, you see the old pictures of Mongolia, and you see a lot of people have small heads, and you see a lot of people have really small heads today. And you could tell by the looks on their faces and their demeanor and the people around them that nobody regards these people as having any kind of mental infirmity or something. But you do have to understand that we do think differently than people who have a different shape of head, and we're different from people in the areas around us and people in Europe and all that. So if some of these people, we strongly advise do not go to these places. Others, if you are going to go to these places, you need to be aware of it and maybe go when you're older, like in your second natural life or something like that, because some of us live a really long time. And just plan for it and prepare and be informed when you go. So it's, you know, and then we can sit there and quantify it and talk about the specifics of it, but that's kind of proprietary information, kind of a matter of national security.